In this demonstration, we're going to focus on data center and private cloud management, specifically network virtualization. Now, customers want an easy way to seamlessly extend their data centers to the cloud. And today, there are technical challenges in making such seamless hybrid cloud architectures. Network virtualization provides the concept of a virtual network that is independent of the underlying physical network. With this concept of virtual networks, which are composed of one or more virtual subnets, the exact location of the IP subnet is decoupled from the virtual network topology. As a result, customers can easily move their subnets to the cloud while preserving their existing IP addresses and topology in that cloud so that existing services continue to work unaware of the physical location of the subnets. That is, network virtualization enables a seamless hybrid cloud. In addition to the cloud, many organizations are consolidating their data centers and creating private clouds to internally get the efficiency and scalability benefits of cloud architectures. Network virtualization provides better flexibility and efficiency for private clouds by decoupling a business unit's virtual network topology from the actual physical network topology. In this way, the business units can easily share an internal private cloud while being isolated from each other. The data center operations team has the flexibility to deploy and dynamically move workloads anywhere in the data center without server interruptions, providing better operational efficiencies and an overall more effective data center. So let's have a practical demonstration on how you can use network virtualization in your organization today. In System Center 2012 SP1, I can now easily view all my virtual networks in one location. In this example, we have two divisions of my parent organization being hosted by my IT department. Each division has their own private cloud, resources, and virtual network. The first one here, Tailspin Sales, uses a 10.29.29.0 IP address range. And my Contoso Finance network also uses a 10.29.29.0 address range. Two exact IP address ranges on a single system, but fully and securely isolated from each other. Network virtualization provides a full network multi-tenancy, allowing each tenant to use the network allocation which is best for them, regardless of any other tenant. Now, if I examine the fabric view of the actual network share, both tenants are utilizing my CorpNet 01 network, which in fact has an IP range of 192.168.1.0. But how can my divisions use one set of IPs and the actual network use another? To show this, let's open a great visual tool called the Network Virtualization Viewer. You can now see exactly how my network virtualized deployment of these two divisions are configured. I have two physical sites which utilize the network address, which we will call the provider address. This is using the 192.168.1.0 range we saw for CorpNet 01, and each VMM host, or Virtual Machine Manager host, has a single provider address for any and all of the VMs hosted on its network virtualized system. In this example here with our two sites, AMS or Amsterdam and PHX or Phoenix, you can see four different provider addresses, two in each site, which shows we have two physical servers per site hosting our VMs. But here is where things get interesting. The provider address is the address which is used to route the packets between sites and servers. However, this is transparent to the actual VMs and workloads they are using. Each VM also has a customer address. Think of this as the address you see when you do an IP config or ping a machine. In all essence, this is the IP address of the VMs, and in this case, it's the virtual IP address. It looks and feels real to the VMs, workloads, and users, and can be used exactly the same way as you'd use a physical IP address. Now, if you cast your mind back to the first screen we showed, our two divisions or tenants have exactly the same IP address range. And if you look at the viewer again, for Amsterdam, you'll see a set of VMs, one in each tenant, that have exactly the same IP address. In this case, 10.29.29.3. And in fact, there is another set of VMs with the same IP address also of 10.29.29.4 in the Phoenix site. But as we mentioned, these two companies are fully isolated from each other, even though they may have the same IP range and even addresses. They are fully shielded from each other's network. So let's look at the two companies' web applications to show this. Firstly, Contoso at 10.29.29.3, and then Tailspin, also at 10.29.29.3. Clients and servers within their own virtual network can communicate with each other and are fully isolated from the other virtual networks in the environment. But fully secured and isolated multi-tenancy is only one of the great features network virtualization provides. I also have amazing amounts of flexibility with the movement of VMs in my organization. As my IP address is virtualized, it is not incumbent on the actual provider IP and can move within the network and keep its IP address. And in fact, I can move entire virtual subnets from one provider address range to another and not change my VM's IP addresses. Now let's return to Virtual Machine Manager, where I have the VM and services view open. What I want to do is look at all the VMs that are currently hosted on my Amsterdam site, and I want to select one of the Tailspin servers, which is actually hosting the website, which you remember had the IP address of 10.29.29.3, which was the same IP address as the VM in the Contoso network. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to live migrate this to a completely new site and server using Shared Nothing Live Migration, where I can actually live migrate a running and accessible workload using no shared storage, nothing except a network connection, with no downtime and no end user interruption, even when I may be going from my Amsterdam data center to my Phoenix data center. I simply drag and drop this. It will actually do a quick analysis of the end environment to ensure it can support my VM, things like virtual CPUs, memory, storage. And now I just simply hit the Migrate VM button. And now my VM is live migrating. It is still fully accessible even through the entire live migration period. And remember, we are using Shared Nothing Live Migration here, so it's copying the VHD files across the wire as well. And that's it. Our VM has now been fully migrated. Let's go check on in its new site in Phoenix. You see that our SalesWeb Tailspin server now resides on the server, and we've fully migrated this utilizing Shared Nothing Live Migration with no downtime. And if we bring up our Network Virtualization Viewer tool, you can see that we've continued to keep our IP address for the VM, even though the underlying provider address has changed and its subnet has changed. And while we've moved sites and servers, our communication between the VMs continues without interruption. So in summary, network virtualization provides policy-based, software-controlled networking, which reduces the management overhead that is faced by enterprises when they're expanding their dedicated clouds. Network virtualization also provides better flexibility for cloud hosting providers, scalability for managing virtual machines, and higher resource utilization. Thank you.